Hello, I'm Gary Johnson from the University of Minnesota. I'm a professor in the Department of Forest Resources. And for this segment, we're going to talk about the different options for purchasing nursery stock. We refer to them as rooting type options. So option number one is bare rooted. And we have a bare rooted linden tree here. One of the nice things about bare rooted trees is they're light. This probably weighs maybe 5 pounds at the most. The second thing about bare rooted trees that's nice is you see exactly where to plant. There are the roots. The disadvantage to a bare root system is it dries out real fast. So there are two ways you can use bare root trees. One is you get them in the spring when they're dormant and plant them. And the second is, like with this, you get them in the spring, you heal them in either wood chips or pea stone, and then you can pull them out. Today's late June, and you can pull it out in late June and plant it with no harm done. But the challenge is keeping the roots moist. And that is probably the main reason why some people or some cities choose not to use bare root trees. The second type of rooting type would be a container or containerized. And there are quite a few different containers now available on the market. I'll kind of go through the pros and cons. This is our conventional plastic smooth-sided container. It's the one that you're probably most commonly going to see, and it's been around for a long, long time. They come in various sizes. Sometimes they're referenced as 1 gallon or 2 or 5 gallon. More commonly now, they talk about a number 5, a number 10, a number 15. So this is number 5. One of the newer developments in containerized systems is the air root pruning containers. And if you look at this, it has all these vertical slots in here. And when roots hit that, it kills the tip of the root, which does not kill the plant. And then that causes it to root more prolifically back into the soil wall of the plant. Another type are the bags. And we have 3 different types of bags here. They're all synthetic. This is a number 15. We have a really nice crab apple growing on this. Nice handles to it. These work really well, again, because you develop a good root system. They're easy to carry around to the site. You have to remove all of these bags at planting time. Just take a knife, cut up, remove them. But you get a really, really good root system developed in there. If you are a garden center or you're going to be holding them for a while, sometimes they'll have these bags and they're coated with a poly coating that keeps the soil from drying out so quickly, because the soil does dry out quickly in something like this. Again, when you plant, cut the bag, remove it, plant. And then the final is pure synthetic. And unfortunately, I'm bringing this one in because I've seen in different garden centers the instructions, plant the bag and all. Do not do that. This is synthetic. This will be around a lot longer than I'll be around. So at planting time, again, cut it, remove the plant from the bag. It's good to go. Now we're going to go over and look at a Balden burlap tree. And one thing before we leave here that I want you to notice is I've been able to pick up the bare root trees. This probably weighs about, I don't know, 80 pounds, maybe at the very, very most. These, you know, 15, 20 pounds, 30 pounds. All of them are fairly easy for one person to manage. Now we'll go look at Balden burlap trees. All right, we're at the final rooting type that you can purchase, which is called Balden burlapped. And if you look at it this closely, the reason why they call it that is there is a soil ball and it's held together with burlap, which is inside of a wire basket. The wire basket you can see showing up right there. Put the hay hook in it. The advantage of this is it does a really good job of keeping the roots moist because you do have the soil ball. The other nice thing about this is if you remember the size of those previous containers, they're quite a bit smaller than this. So with Balden burlap trees, you can dig up field grown trees to pretty good size. Actually, if you have the right piece of equipment, up to a 10 inch diameter tree. The problem with them, those are all the good parts. The problem with, they're heavy. And so the others, I was able to pick them up relatively easy. With these, I can't do it. And normally you have to have a piece of heavy equipment or something like this. If you had three or four people, you could take a hay hook, put it right into the wire basket, and with enough people, you could lift it up, and then we would all have bad backs for the rest of our lives. And that's Balden Burlap.